Have you got a message to all the fans out there who voted for you in this production for tonight's award?
Oh, I would just thank you so much is what I want to say. It means the world. It means everything. It's a unique thing, a relationship between an actor and an audience, is particularly on stage. And the audience is part of the occasion every night. There's a unique chemistry that I hope is palpable. I know I can feel it. So to have this compliment and this honour from them is massive, huge, bigger than you probably think.
You've been giving stuff back to fans this week, the first trailer for Crimson Peak. Can you tell us what we can expect from that and working with a master like Guillermo?
He's incredible. Anyone who's seen his films needs no persuasion of his creative powers from me. We made it about last year, and it's very scary. And I think it's full of some interesting surprises. And I don't want to give too much away here. So I just hope people love the trailer and look forward to the film.
In Skull Island as well. Fantastic to be part of that legacy of King Kong. What made you want to be a part of that, and what do you think is going to set that apart from all of the other Kongs that have preceded it?
Well, really, it was Jordan Vogt Roberts has such an extraordinary vision. His story, which I know he hasn't revealed to anyone yet, is King Kong, is a King Kong movie you've never seen before, and it's very ambitious and epic and fresh and new in its vision and design, and the characters are amazing, and chance to work with Legendary again, who made Crimson Peak, and I loved what they did with Godzilla, and so a number of things. I was wanting to work with Jordan particularly, whose idea is amazing, and the story and the script and the studio. So yeah, it was a very easy yes.
Tell us about the Hank Williams biopic, of course. I mean, such an icon of music, and to get a chance to play him must be truly magnificent.
I mean, that's just a privilege beyond my wildest dreams. I mean, he's an American icon, and many people see him as the godfather of American songwriting, and I still, it's very hard to talk about it because I still feel very close to it. So I still feel like I'm related to him in some way. I spent so long immersed in his world, in his music, in his life. It's in the post-production it's post-production moment right now, and Mark Abraham's editing away, and he seems very happy, and I can't wait to show it to people. It's gonna be new. It's gonna be interesting.